Hello dear students, this is Dr. Agnes Kharath and with me you are studying Organic Evolution. Before we actually begin with the subject, let us start with the meaning of the word Organic Evolution. What is Organic Evolution? Organic Evolution is a slow, gradual, continuous and irreversible changes through which the present-day complex forms have descended from their simple pre-existing forms of the past. So we know what is organic evolution. Now, let us start with our first chapter. It is introduction. So I have divided this lesson in two parts. In part 1, we are going to learn origin of life, and in part 2, we'll be learning about origin of eukaryotic cells, particularly mitochondria, plastids and symbionts. At the outset, let us ask this question that how the universe came into existence. Big Bang. It is presumed that the universe came into existence with a single titanic explosion called as Big Bang about 15,000 million years ago. With the Big Bang, all the matter and tremendous energy came into existence. The fragments of the fireball expanded and cooled to give rise to many more celestial bodies. In due course of time, this resulted in the formation of solar system consisting of sun and planets. Thus, the Earth presumed to have originated about 4.6 billion years ago. The origin of life on Earth is also called as protobiogenesis. So, it is clear that the life came into existence from the non-living substance of the primordial Earth about 3 billion years ago. Let us learn some theories which will explain origin of life on Earth, which is also called as protobiogenesis. The first theory is theory of special creation. This is the oldest theory of all the theories. The Spanish monk Father Sudres proposed this theory. It is supported by many religions and civilizations. This theory proposed that all the living beings on the earth were created by God or by some supernatural power. So this theory strongly believes in supernatural power. Our next theory is theory of panspermia theory or cosmozoic theory. This theory was proposed by Richter in 1865. It is also known as panspermia theory. So this theory proposed that life on Earth came from a distant planet in the form of spores or microorganisms. It was also called cosmozoa or panspermia, which were preserved inside meteoroids. What are meteoroids? Meteoroids are the masses of matter which fall on Earth from outer surface. Meteoroids struck the barren Earth to release the cosmozoa and helped in the development of various creatures. Recently, NASA has reported fossils of bacteria-like organisms on a piece of Martian rock recovered from Antarctica region. So this is about cosmozoic theory. Our next theory is theory of spontaneous generation, which is also called as theory of abiogenesis or autobiogenesis, which means self-life formation. Initially, this theory was put forth by Greek philosophers in 600 BC. It was supported by Aristotle. This theory proposed that life originated from non-living material spontaneously without any interruption. So this theory explains that frogs must have developed from falling drops of rain, and fish, they developed from the leaf. So this is the spontaneous generation. Now here is a great man, Louis Pasteur, who disproves the theory of spontaneous generation and gave the scientific explanation that life originated only from pre-existing life or biogenesis. So Louis Pasteur, he supported and promoted biogenesis. Biogenesis is our next theory, which tells us about like begets like. In 1668, the Italian physician Francesco Redi, Spallanzani and Louis Pasteur performed an experiment to disprove the spontaneous generation. People believed for thousands of years that live maggots could be spun from dead meat. In this experiment, they put meat in three jars. One jar was an open container, one with a cork sealed container, the third jar with a gauze or fine mesh covered on it. Flies laid their eggs on the meat in the open jar. The eggs hatched to maggots, then young flies. Unable to reach the meat, flies laid their eggs on the gauze of the second jar and the maggots hatched on the gauze, not in the meat. And no eggs were laid on the cork-sealed jar, so it remained free of maggots. So with this repeatable experiment, this scientist proved scientifically that life, that is here the maggots, come from life, that is flies, and not from non-life, the dead meat. So the important lesson here we are going to learn is like begets like. This theory of biogenesis could not explain origin of first life on earth, but could satisfactorily it explain continuity of life on earth. It opposes spontaneous generation very strongly. Living organisms are always produced from pre-existing living forms by reproduction and not from non-living or lifeless matter. So this is one of the important theory of evolution, theory of biogenesis. Now the next theory is modern self-assembly theory. This theory occurred due to inherent property of chemical molecules of self-organization and self-assembly. This models include the primordial events of conversion of micromolecules to macromolecules to organize cells like microsystems, and these events were speculated to be probably rugged, simple, fast and occur frequently on the earth. Schmidt, who has synthesized collagen from simple micromolecules, gave the first demonstration of this theory. Modern self-assembly theory is also called as theory of chemical evolution. The Russian scientist Alexander Oparin and British scientist J.B.S. Haldane proposed this theory of chemical evolution. So, this theory proposed that life originated by progressive changes in the chemicals in due course of time. First life came into existence by the combination of chemical compounds by constant chemical reactions over a long period of time. This modern concept is known as chemical evolution of life or self-assembly theory of origin of life. This theory is also called as biochemical origin of life or molecular evolution. So the entire process of chemical evolution of this theory is divided into following steps. First step is origin of Earth and its primitive atmosphere. Second, formation of ammonia, water and methane molecules. Third step is synthesis of simple organic compound. J.B.S. Haldane described the sea containing molecules of these organic substances in abundance as the hot diluted soup, or it is called as primitive broth. So synthesis of simple organic compound took place in following manner. First was formation of complex organic compound, then formation of nucleic acid, then formation of protoboyant or pre-cell, which was followed by formation of first cell, and thus biological evolution happened or occurred. So one by one, we are going to learn all these steps of chemical evolution. First step is origin of Earth and its primitive atmosphere. The origin of life on Earth is closely related to the origin of Earth itself. Earth originated about 4.6 billion years ago. When it was broken from the sun, it was glowing fire and rotating cloud of hot gases, vapors of various elements. It was called as nebulas. As Earth slowly moves away from sun, its temperature decreases, which leads to condensation of gas. Heavy metals like iron, nickel, etc. sank to center and formed the solid core of Earth. Lightest elements like helium, hydrogen, oxygen, etc. occupied atmosphere of Earth. So atmosphere of primitive Earth was reducing type and there was no free oxygen. So this is how origin of Earth and primitive atmosphere took place. Next step is formation of ammonia, water and methane. Primitive atmosphere of Earth was very hot. As it slowly cooled, the lighter elements started to react with each other. Early atmosphere was rich in hydrogen, carbon, nitrogen and sulfur, of which hydrogen was very active. It combines with nitrogen to form ammonia, with oxygen to form water, and with carbon to form methane. As temperature was high, ammonia and methane remained as gases and water as steam. As years passes, temperature of Earth decreased, steam condensed into water, which resulted in rain and Earth became cold. Water accumulated and led to formation of river. Compounds like ammonia, methane, etc. were dissolved in water and accumulated in sea. So this is how formation of ammonia, water and methane took place. Thus the first chemical formed on Earth were water, ammonia and methane. Third step is synthesis of simple organic compounds. The atmosphere then did not contain ozone layer and thus ultraviolet radiation reached the Earth's surface directly. Under influence of available energy source, that is ultraviolet rays, radiations, lightning and volcanic activities, the early molecules of hydrocarbons, ammonia and water showed condensation, polymerization, oxidation and reduction reaction. This resulted in the formation of biologically important molecules like monosaccharides, amino acids, purines, pyrimidines, fatty acids and glycerol. All these simple organic molecules accumulated at the bottom of water bodies, which is called as hot dilute soup or primitive broth. It did not show any degradation due to absence of free oxygen and enzymes. So, how formation of complex organic compound took place? The primitive broth was neutral and free from oxygen. Polymerization took place and simple organic molecules aggregated to form new complex organic molecules like polysaccharides, fats, proteins, nucleosides and nucleotides. Polymerization of amino acids formed protoproteins, which later formed proteins. The formation of protein molecule is considered as a landmark in origin of life. Proteins, which are also enzymes, accelerated the rate of other chemical reactions. Formation of nucleic acid. Nucleic acid formed by aggregation of phosphoric acid, sugar, purines and pyrimidines. They were linked in various combinations to form different types of nucleotides. Thousands of nucleotides joined together to form nucleic acids like DNA and RNA. Nucleic acid acquired self-replicating ability, which is fundamental property of all living forms. Then formation of protobiont or pre-cells. Nucleic acids along with inorganic and organic molecules formed the first form of life called as protobionts or pre-cells. The proteins formed colloidal hydrophilic complexes surrounded by water molecules. Oparin called these aggregates as coacervates, while Sidney Fox called them as protenoids or microspheres. Then, formation of first cell took place. Nucleic acid in pre-cells had the capacity to multiply, but gradually it started directing series of chemical reactions like protein synthesis. This was significant step in transformation of pre-cell into a cell. First cell was anaerobic, heterotrophic and obtained energy by chemoheterotrophic process. This chemical evolution led to biological evolution. So thus biological evolution happened. First cell or primitive cells were marine and heterotrophic in nature. Growth and multiplication of these cells caused depletion in the food and increase in carbon dioxide due to fermentation. This results into formation of chromophores. Chromophores had the ability to trap light energy and convert it into chemical energy. This helped in transformation of heterotrophs into autotrophs. Due to release of oxygen as byproduct of photosynthesis, the primitive reducing atmosphere was slowly and gradually converted into oxidizing atmosphere. So this is about biological evolution. Urey and Miller has performed experiment in 1953. They provided the first experimental evidence in support of chemical evolution of oparin. They simulated the prebiotic conditions on Earth. Urey and Miller designed a glass apparatus called as spark discharge apparatus. The apparatus was first sterilized and evacuated. Methane, ammonia and hydrogen gases were pumped in the proportion of 1:2:2 into the glass chamber. A tube carrying water vapor was also connected to the chamber. Lightning effect was mimicked by electric discharge carbon arc spark in the chamber. Process of evaporation and precipitation was also simulated by use of heating mantle and condenser. The mixture of methane, ammonia and hydrogen was exposed continuously to electric discharge for several days, causing the gases to interact, after which they were condensed. From this setup, they obtained simple organic compounds such as amino acids, urea, lactic acids, etc. This experiment strongly supports that the simple molecules present in the Earth's early atmosphere combine to form organic building blocks of life. So this is all about origin of life. The first part. In this part, we have studied several theories of origin of life. Thank you.